Welcome to CN2 Today. Good morning to you. I'm your host, Renee O'Neill, and we are off-site here at Z Bakery in Fort Mill, and because it's National Sticky Bun Day, and look at this delicious sticky bun that our friends for us made. This looks amazing. I can't wait to bite into it. And before we talk more about that, we just want to take a minute to honor Reverend Billy Graham. Many of you know he passed away this morning. At his home in North Carolina. He was 99 years old. He would have been 100 in November. I remember watching his crusades growing up with my family. He always stood by his message of Christ. Tonight at 6, we'll have local reaction from pastors here in the Tri-County and people just remembering his life. And also at 6, our reporter Alexandria Savage brings us part 3 of her Integration of Education series. We head to Lancaster for some history that happened in Lancaster and how it affected a lot of people's lives growing up in that time. And also the Fort Mill School District, they honor a lot of people in the school district and the Fort Mill Rotary Club. They are also presenting some pretty big checks to some local organizations. So we'll have all that tonight at 6, but right now we're going to get back to the sticky fun. Again, we're here at Z Bakery in Fort Mill. This is Kristen Zimmerman. She is with Z Bakery, the owner. Thank you for letting us come in today.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you for coming.
So tell us about these delicious sticky buns. How were they made?
Well, everything at Z Bakery is made in-house. The sticky bun is kind of like our cinnamon roll. It's a yeast dough that we make ourselves.
Okay.
We knead it out. We get it in the round shape. They have to rise for like an hour.
Oh, goodness.
Then you bake them. It's a pretty long process.
The
pecans are roasted, and it's our own caramel sauce. But they are definitely worth the time.
Yeah.
Very popular.
Okay. And I was looking up information about sticky buns. I believe they're from Germany, and they're a specialty. I believe it was in Pennsylvania, so they're still out there. A lot of people are making them and everything. And I also read that when you make them, you flip them over, and that's how the sticky gets on top. Is that the
same?
Okay.
Yep. That's true.
Okay.
You know a lot.
Yeah, I was researching sticky buns, so I knew what I was talking about today. And Z Bakery. So tell me about, it's beautiful in here. It's so quaint.
Thank you.
Talk about your business.
Well, we started out 5 years ago as an online bakery. Had a really big passion for that. Started out using my grandma's old recipes that she had growing up. After doing that for a long time, we found this space and we opened up. After being here for a little while, we started doing lunch, which has gotten really popular and we love having everyone. We started doing venue rentals, which this room right here is actually used for a couple baby showers, bridal showers.
Wow.
We also do the art on the wall is from probably 15 to 20 different local artists.
Okay.
So that's really exciting. And
you can buy it while you're here?
You can.
It? Okay.
Yeah.
There you go.
Lot of people still come in just to shop for the art. So
okay. If
you come in here, you can get a sweet treat, a savory treat, get some artwork, and maybe book a party. So.
Okay. And I hear you guys are busy, so you need to book in advance.
Yes. For custom cakes, we book about 3 months in advance. And for rentals to use the space, it's about 2 months in advance.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah. So pretty full.
Now, what are your hours so people maybe can stop by and see you?
We are open Tuesday through Friday, 10 to 3. And then Saturday and Sunday, we're open 9 to 3.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for us coming here today. Chris, photographer behind the camera. I'm going to put down the microphone and take a bite of this delicious sticky bun. And then we'll be back with more CN2 Today after this. Have you eaten any yet?
Oh, yeah. It's really good.
It's a big bite. It's okay. So good. We'll be back after this. Welcome back to CN2 Today. We're here in the York County Library in the Children's Department with all these wonderful books behind us. We have Teresa Creed. She is the Executive Director of the Early Learning Partnership of York County. Teresa, I know you guys have a big event coming up next weekend, March 3rd, the Run for Reading. But let's talk about the importance of reading, why this run's important. Talk
Thanks.
A little bit about that.
Oh, Renee, it's so important. We're a nonprofit that serves all of York County. And our focus is really getting kids ready for school. And that involves using books. So we are promoting our race and the run for reading, because all proceeds go to purchase books to go to children in York County.
Okay, and why is it so important that children start reading at such a young age, start being engaged, letting their parents read to them?
Right.
Talk about that a little bit.
Well, it's really important because that's how our children grow their vocabulary. Mm-hmm. That is how the synapses in the brain, all those little neurons start to fire. And for parents, it's not so much about reading word for word those, you know, the stories. Mm-hmm. It's about talking, using vocabulary, growing and expanding the brain. By age 3, 80% of a child's brain is developed.
Wow, okay.
So we have a very small window to get kids engaged with books. And books are just a great tool. You know,
mm-hmm.
just like you build a house, you use a hammer.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know, you build a child's brain, you use books and language.
And what age should parents start reading to their children?
Actually, before they're born.
Okay.
Just start
okay.
talking, reading, and then as they grow, they will start to be more engaged. At first, you know, that baby might take that book and stick it in its mouth,
mm-hmm.
and that's developmentally appropriate.
Okay.
You're just wanting to make sure they become friendly with books. And then as they are aging and getting further, ready to go to school, we want them to be on grade level with reading. And by third grade, we really want the majority of our kids reading. Because in York County currently,
mm-hmm.
49% is the average of not reading on grade level.
It's a lot.
And,
yeah.
and that becomes not just about school readiness, that
mm-hmm.
becomes about workforce and economic development.
And I know this run for reading, I know this is another way to get it out there about the importance of it. Let's talk about this event. So it's March 3rd, downtown Rock Hill. Tell us some details about it.
So we have the 4-mile run,
okay.
and then we also have a relay. So you can, if you don't want to run all 4 miles,
okay.
you can get three other buddies, and the four of you can run 1 mile each in the relay. We also have a costume category. Last year we had a group from York County Natural Gas. They always show up with great costumes. Last year it was the Three Little Pigs and the
nice.
Big Bad Wolf. And they were our winners. So you can do costumes, children's book characters. And then we will have the Tumble Bus there that day. So the Tumble Bus promotes literacy and music. And physical activity. We will have select physical therapy doing a pre-race stretch, and
wow.
then we will have Synergy Yoga doing yoga in the park at 9 after
okay.
the race.
Okay, yeah. So a lot of things going on for
yes.
everyone.
Yes.
Okay, now is there a certain time when you need to sign up? Talk about how people can get
yeah.
involved.
Yeah, so you can register right up until the day of the event.
Okay.
You can come to the park that morning. We're hoping we're going to have lovely warm weather like
yes.
we've been having. And then if you don't want to run but you want to support ELP, you can either be a sleep-in supporter where
okay.
you can go on the website and get the t-shirt, or you can just make a donation. And all of our funds go into promoting early literacy here in York County and getting books into the hands of children.
Okay. Well, Teresa, thank you so much.
Thanks,
so much
Renee.
Great information. And we hope to see you guys out there on March 3rd. And we'll be right back after this with more CN2 Today.
Your community. Your lifestyle. Your entertainment. Every weekday, starting at 11:30, we will bring you a brand new show called CN2 Today. Each will be filled with local stories, inside scoops, things you care about in the Tri-County. Join us online first at cn2.com in February. Then look out for our on-air launch coming in March, only on Comporium Channel 1102.
Welcome back to CN2 Today. We're here in the studio with Jenna Woods with CN2 at the Movies. Jenna, you're talking about two really interesting movies that are coming out this weekend. Tell me about the first one.
So the first one that's coming out is Annihilation. This is going to be a sci-fi thriller. It has Natalie Portman, Gina Rodriguez in it. And it's a different take. When I was watching the preview, it kind of reminded me of Alien, and I know Alien has a big following, so I don't want to disappoint anyone, but this one looks just as thrilling.
Okay.
It's about kind of like this alternate realm that the scientists discover, and a biologist, her husband, goes into this realm, and when he comes out, he's like deathly ill.
Oh.
And so she and a group that she chooses ventures into this alternate realm, and tries to find out what's making her husband sick in order to save his life.
Okay.
So that one's, again, rated R, and it stars Natalie Portman. She's always a crowd pleaser.
Yes, she
and
is. I love
Gina
her.
Rodriguez.
Okay. And there's another one. I'm Rachel McAdams. She's one of my favorite actresses. Talk about that one.
Yes. This one is going to be hilarious. It's also a thriller, but it has a lot more comedy, or more comedy than Annihilation has. And it is called Game Night, and it stars Rachel McAdams, Jason Bateman, and Chandler Baxley. And he was in Friday Night Lights, and if you watch Netflix, he is in a series on Netflix.
Okay. So. Talk about, and that is it, they start out to, like, their own game night, and it kind of has some twists and turns a little
yes.
bit.
Yes. and so the couple who Rachel McAdams and Jason Bateman play, they are hosting a game night, and it's a weekly thing, and they're, you know, very much normal couples, and Jason Bateman's brother decides to throw a wrench in and plan this murder mystery game night.
Okay.
And this murder mystery ends up being not a game, and these couples, like, go throughout this whole movie, and they think it's a game, and then all of a sudden it's like, uh-oh, they discover they're actually in real trouble, and they need to finish playing the so-called game in order to save the person that gets kidnapped at the beginning.
Okay, and what's that one rated?
That one's also rated R.
Okay.
So this one is definitely an adult date night movie.
Okay, fun. Well, what is your favorite movie, since you critique these movies a little bit?
Yeah, my all-time favorite movie, it has been since I was in ninth grade, is Dirty Dancing.
I love that movie.
To me, just nothing compares to it. I know people think it's cheesy, but there's just something about it that I absolutely love. And a fun fact is that I love it so much is that my husband and I are going to the actual hotel that the film was shot at in the mountains of North Carolina this summer. So I'm really excited about that.
Okay, so I guess people go to that hotel because of the experience.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
I think even in the summer they have I don't think it's called the Dirty Dancing Festival, but it is some sort of festival that kind of commemorates the film. And
neat.
So they play all the music, and they do all the dancing sequences and have the activities that you see in the actual movie. So
that's going to be a fun trip.
Oh, yeah.
And I know I love A Walk to Remember. That's probably my favorite movie. And you were saying this is the 16th year for
yes.
the movie, 16th anniversary.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm a huge Mandy Moore fan who plays the leading role in the film. And she actually released on her Instagram that this was the 16th year and they were doing a special DVD release this year.
Nice.
So that's probably going to be, in the Walmart and Targets. So definitely if you're, a fan, go
oh,
get
yeah.
the movie.
I love that movie. I used to, when it came out, I was in love with Shane West when I was little. So I would take a picture of the TV so I could put it in my room.
Oh,
I know
goodness.
That's probably silly, but
it
I love that movie. Well, make sure you go check out those movies tonight or this weekend. Remember, they are rated R, so definitely for adults. But we want to get to your hometown tours for some fun things for your family and friends that's happening this weekend locally in our area. This Saturday, the 24th, at the Gateway Conference Center in Richburg, there will be the 13th Annual Joy Gardening Symposium put on by the York County Master Gardeners. To register and for more information, just go to the website on your screen.
Also on Saturday at 6, the VFW 2889 Auxiliary presents Happy Days Are Here Again. Take a stroll back in time to the ultimate 1950s sock hop. The fundraiser will take place at the VFW Ballroom on West Main Street in Rock Hill. Tickets are $10.
And at the Clover School District Auditorium Saturday at 8 p.m., Pudding Stone will be performing. Pudding Stone is a band blending sounds of medieval to modern with shades of folk, classical, Renaissance, and more. Tickets are $15.
And interested in needlework? Here's your chance. The daytime event Saturday is at the Fort Mill Public Library. All skills are welcome, including crochet, knitting, needlepoint, and more. No registration required. Just bring your own supplies.
And also on Saturday, bring your own telescope for a telescope clinic. Those with the Culture and Heritage Museum of York County will show you how to use it and more. Registration is required. Call the number on your screen or email the address to reserve your spot.
And moving on to Sunday, the Women's Club of Rock Hill is presenting a wedding fair to remember at its clubhouse on Aiken Avenue. There will be everything you need to plan your perfect day.
All right. Well, thank you, Jenna, so much for joining us on this entertainment. Make sure you go and check out all those fun events and also check out the movies this weekend. We'll be back after this. Welcome back to CN2 Today. It's What's Cooking Wednesday, and we are in the famous Southern Salads in Rock Hill. Here we have the owner, Debbie Henderson. Thanks for letting us come in here before
you
open.
Thank you for being here.
Yes, and we smell some food behind us cooking with our chef right here. She's cooking away. So tell us about your three main dishes that she's preparing. I guess some of these are the most popular ones.
Yes, actually they are. She is making the Papa Nick burger. Clay spent a lot of time trying to get it just right, to get the right combination of meat and fat and everything to make that burger just right.
Okay.
And then on top of that burger, we put our homemade tomato barbecue. Now, we smoke the barbecue ourselves. We have four different sauces. We have the mustard, the tomato, the vinegar, which takes care of the Carolinas.
Then
we also have a special blend that Clay created. But for this particular burger, we put the tomato on top. And then she puts some French fried onions on top. So it's quite a burger.
Delicious.
It's a handful. And if you want a little extra touch, put a piece of bacon on it.
Ooh,
yummy.
You can't go wrong with bacon on a burger.
No, you can't. The other thing that she's making is the blackened chicken pasta.
That looks delicious.
Now, this recipe comes from a restaurant that Clay worked at before. And just before the owner passed, he gave us his recipes.
Oh, wow.
So this recipe has been well known in Rock Hill for several years, and she is putting that together for us. And then she's also making a crab cake BLT.
Mm.
Yum. And as you can see, we always do our seafood in separate pans. That way you don't have to worry about food allergies.
Okay. So would you say these are some of the main dishes people come here to eat when you guys are open? Or
I think people always come here for the chicken salad.
You can't go wrong with that. We're going to head over there. I know that you guys have some of that to go. A lot of people get that. I know it's getting picnic season.
Absolutely.
Even people going to tailgate. So tell us a little bit about your chicken salad, your tuna salad, all that good stuff.
Absolutely. We make everything fresh more than once a day, especially in this store. We have the pasta salads, the egg salad, ham salad, the tuna salad, as you said. We have everything here that you'd want to take either on picnic or tailgating. A lot of people use it for weddings or parties, graduations, that kind of thing. It's also really good for funerals, so that you don't have to take a great big tray to somebody's house. You can take this and it can actually go into their refrigerator and they don't have to worry about it taking up a great deal of space.
And it lasts a long time. I've gotten even the small ones, and they make a lot of sandwiches, which
Absolutely.
Is really good.
Absolutely, they do.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's great to have here.
Okay. Now, I know that some of these dishes are already plated up. Clay, he can come on. Clay is your husband and also owner. You guys own this together. And he's going to be bringing out the pasta, which looks absolutely delicious. It is steaming. Oh, my goodness. Hey, Clay, that looks so good.
Thanks.
Yeah, so this is the finished product. So just tell us about the final touches on these.
Well, the chicken pasta, as Debbie said, came from an old restaurant that Jerry Dozier owned. It's a blackened chicken pasta. It is fantastic. Mm. The Papa Nick burger with the barbecue on it, it was great. My son and my daughter-in-law and Debbie and I were sitting around talking about different menu items, and we came up with that.
Okay.
And the crab cake BLT, which everyone has just went crazy over, Debbie came up with.
Okay, go Debbie.
I got it down at the beach.
Looks great. Well, Clay, talk a little bit about Southern salads. I know you guys are very popular. Everyone, when you think about chicken salad, pimento cheese, this is where people go. So tell us how you got the start.
Well, as I said, Jerry Dozier owned it it was 2004 when he started it, and he asked me to come to work for him. I'd run another restaurant for him, and I just loved him to death, and I did, and within 2 years, I had bought the place from him. It was a little teeny place. It was it was fun. It was just me and two little part-time people, and then we moved here, and it's grown into what it is today.
And I know you have a location in Fort Mill as well.
We do. We are talking about opening up a third location soon. But then I wonder why. So we'll see.
Well, what are your hours like so people can come in and enjoy some of these wonderful dishes?
Rock Hill is 10 to 8 Monday through Saturday. Fort Mill right now is 10 to 7, and on Saturdays 10 to 3.
So you guys are busy all the time, I know, when I walk, when I come by.
Yes, we are very blessed. We are very thankful, yes.
Well, thank you guys so much for letting us come in here. It's been fun seeing all your wonderful dishes. I know that we're going to make a lot of people hungry, which is a good thing.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
And
we'll be back Friday with a brand new CN2 Today on CN2.com.